As News 5 Live was wrapping up on Friday, there were several shooting incidents in the old capital. Sometime around 8 p.m., 22-year-old Harrison Smith was riding on North Front Street. As he reached its intersection with Pickstock Street, two men riding on separate bicycles opened fire on him. Smith was rushed to the KHMH but succumbed within hours. 23-year-old Eustace Lewis was also injured in the shooting.
Police visited the Kalhushna Memorial Hospital, where they saw two persons suffering from varying degrees of injuries. The first being 32-year-old Harrison Smith of a Police Street address, and the second was 23-year-old Eustace Lewis of a West Collett Canal address. Harrison Smith received several apparent gunshot wounds to the body, and again, unfortunately, just after about 9:45 p.m., he succumbed to his injuries. Lewis remained in a stable condition at the Kalhushna Memorial Hospital.
Immediately following the shooting, police went to Chan Sing Restaurant at the corner of North Front Street and Majestic Alley. There, they rounded up several persons socializing at the establishment. Three of them, 26-year-old Bart Lucas, 26-year-old Daniel Kane, and 18-year-old Oscar Flores, were today arraigned for the murder before Chief Magistrate Anne-Marie Smith. The men were remanded to prison until November 6th, but according to Lucas's sister Naomi, her younger brother is innocent.
He was at Chan Sing Palace. I am comfortable with this. I'm confident of this, you know, because besides what is on the video, you know, he's hanging out with people who he knows from around the neighborhood. Chan Sing Restaurant, they usually socialize there.
That aside, I understand that police officers were patrolling in the area during the duration of this time, and even these persons have not come forward to claim the innocence that your brother has.
You know, I don't expect that these officers who were on patrol will just willfully come forward. They are brothers of the other police officers who are trying to make this case stick. As much as I will say that they were here. It is possible for them. They have the ability because of their knowledge. They were patrolling around here. You know, they were rubbing shoulders with them, because that's a part of the police duties. When you're patrolling the community, you know, you have to rub shoulders with them, you know. And the lower of Chan Sing, they can use the restroom facility. They're in an air-conditioned building. They can buy their water.
Noemi has been doing her groundwork. With the assistance of the proprietors of the restaurant, she showed us minute-by-minute play of her brother at the restaurant at the time of the shooting. He was dressed in a blue jeans, white shirt, and a black durag on his head, all captured on surveillance camera before the shooting and after 9 p.m. when he, along with several others, were detained by police officers.
My lawyer, Tari Musa, has advised me that I will have to do some groundwork, which I have been doing over the weekend. You know, I have to do some groundwork, physically locate the police officers who were doing the foot patrol, you know, who were in the establishment, you know, and I'm going to use the video footage. I have them on camera around and about the place, in there with them. The same place my brother was, they were in there. So I have to round them up, and I need to ask them, you don't remember you saw my brother there? And see if they could say, you know, I wrote down his name in my notebook, you know, he was sitting at the bar, you know, and they could help authenticate what the video is saying.
According to police press officer Rafael Martinez, investigators will take all evidence into consideration.
I am pretty sure that police will left no stone unturned, and I'm sure if that is one of the evidence that would prove whether or not he was indeed a part of the gunmen, or the persons who fired shots, then that will definitely be looked upon by the people investigating this latest shooting incident.
However, for the family, Bart's name will forever be tarnished even after he is proven innocent of the charge.
It's a bell that cannot be unrung, you know. You can't unring that bell. You know, he will always be known as somebody who was charged for murder. And besides that, they won't have people who who will look at the whole picture. They will only hear his name being called. They will track it up to, regular black boy from around through the ghetto, whatever it is. That must he do it.
Dwayne Moody for News 5.